Hi everyone, and welcome back to a brand new Quick Tip by Janus Engineering. My name is Alex, and today I'm going to be demonstrating how to save a lot of time when selecting guiding curves. Today we are going to be looking at this part that I have open in front of us. We are going to be selecting curves that follow this inside corner radius where my mouse is running currently. Using the guiding curve operation, we can finish off the surface. This example will be using the five-axis operation, known as variable axis guiding curves. Now, I've already started creating this operation. We can just double-click into the operation on the left-hand side, and when we look, we can see that we already have a few things specified. The cut area faces are currently highlighted in blue, and I've also set all the pattern settings at the bottom. Now, all we have to do is make changes to the drive geometry section for this operation. We are going to be using a pattern type of constant offset for this scenario, which means we are going to be selecting the guiding curves that go around the selected faces. When we try to just click the edge here, we see that the tangent curve setting is applied, and it will select all the curves tangent to one another. These curves seem to be fine, but when I select another curve on this side, we can see that all of the wall is selected as those are all tangent to one another. That's not what we want for this operation. We will change the setting from tangent to single curve and deselect these curves, and then we would have to go through and individually select all of these curves following the outside of our cut area. As you can imagine, depending on the part, this could take a very long time. Instead, we are going to deselect all of the guide curves that we've already selected, and we're going to go back up to the drop-down menu. And as we know, there are options of single and tangent curves, but today I want to demonstrate how to use the face edge option. To use this selection, all we need to do is simply select the face of the radius and automatically all four edges are populated. When I continue to select the neighbor of the face, then we see that all the edges are inferred and added. We can add the last faces and the selection is already done, just like that. All we need to do now is click the generate path. And just like that, the path was created and finished. We can then begin to verify the path and see the tool move around the radius here. Well, that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching. As always, make sure to drop a like and a follow to stay tuned on all of our quick tips. If you have any questions or recommendations on tips, shoot us a message or drop a comment. See you next time. Bye-bye.
Let's make it real. Janus Engineering.